What happens when a baseball team wants to build a stadium over the land they don't know belongs to someone else? Tonight on 60 Minutes, a man whose life and property fell through the cracks.
Mike Haas, and this little baby here is what I like to call my home. This little piece of land has been in my family for generations upon generations upon generations, and I don't think I'm gonna sell.
Michael now lives inside of a baseball stadium and has adapted to coexisting with the sport.
It's tough living here at O'Brien Field, but it does have its perks. As you can see, I live at a baseball field. I've seen my fair share of baseball games. I've also caught my fair share of foul balls. Yes, I keep the foul balls. I don't give them back, because when it comes onto my porch, it stays on my porch.
Yeah, Mike's a good guy, you know. Prince of Peoria, as we call him. It would be just terrible to see him move out. He's always kind of been there for people when they need him, and he's a local kind of guy.
My family acquired this land back in the 1800s during the Civil War from none other than General Lee. And the Monocan family has tried to acquire this land from me, but being a good American, I believe in tradition and honor and pride.
Yeah, Mike's, I'm all for him staying there, you know. I just say, leave him alone. Leave him alone.
I've been told that once I leave, I'm supposed to pay for every game that I've been to. And that's quite a large sum of money, and you can't make that much money farming on a 3x6 piece of land.
So Michael was forced into finding an alternative way to acquire food. Local restaurant businesses have supported Michael's way of living.
So what I usually do is have this net, and I call one of my good buddies from Jimmy John's. I order 3 sandwiches, hoping that I can catch one of the 3 sandwiches in my net from my porch.
Just throw it over!
That's what I've seen in 5 years. I also like Wednesday nights because it's free hot dogs and peanuts. And what I usually do is, the guys in the concession stand are pretty nice about it. I yell over to them, like, hey, throw me a hot dog. And they throw me a hot dog. It's quite a nice life I've got going so far. Except for some of the employees really hassle me about my little piece of land, and I don't appreciate it sometimes, but when the going gets tough, the tough get going.
Mike Haas, the bane of my existence here in Peoria. Obviously, you know, you've heard that the loophole, as they call it, you know, that he's got this property here at our baseball stadium. It really is just, it's ridiculous. You know, we've tried working with him. He won't leave. He's living on a piece of AstroTurf inside a baseball stadium. I mean, seriously, who does that? I mean, this guy, I don't even know what to say about him. I really don't. It's absolutely ridiculous. It's ludicrous. Pretty much anything you can think of. Just unbelievable. It really is unbelievable. I really don't even know what to say. You can tell, it's just, every time his name comes up, it just, you know, fires me up. It's unbelievable. I can't stand the guy. You know, he's been here for I don't even know how many years. I mean, the ballpark's been here 8. Apparently, he's had this property since the 1800s. The guy's 24 years old. Who bought the property in 1800 is what I want to know. You know, all this legal jargon and crap about I don't even know what this is all about.
Huh. That porch guy. Not sure what I think about him, you know? I mean, how can you just, like, sit on a single porch 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. I mean, I guess I don't have a complete issue with it, other than the fact that we have to deal with him. I mean, he's kind of a hobo, in a sense. We have to bring this work to him. He doesn't come up here. There's no interaction with other humans other than games, and then it's kind of the creepy guy on the porch talking to kids getting their face painted. Kind of weird. Oh yeah, but you know what, he does work for us sometimes, you know, like that wide shot that we need behind the plate. He controls that, I mean, but how much work does that take? Yeah, I'm on the fence. You're talking about Porch Mike. Is that what you can call him? Does he have a name? Wait, does he?
Hey! Give it down over there!
As soon as he steps foot off that AstroTurf thing that he calls his porch, we're back charging him. He's been to every game in 8 years that the stadium's been here. He's never paid for a single ticket. I've almost lost my job twice over this fact, because here I am, the director of ticket sales, and some guy isn't paying for tickets, you know. So as soon as he leaves, we've tried many things before to get him to step off the porch. He just won't do it. And we've gotten, you know, we're going to get more and more creative ways, because as soon as he comes off that porch, he's going to pay for it. He's going to pay for it dearly.
Yeah, I mean, the fact that they're still making him pay to get these games is absolutely ridiculous. Absolutely ridiculous. I mean, why would they do that? This guy's been in Peoria. I mean, you know, our Prince of Peoria. You know, this guy's been here before O'Brien. Come on. Absolutely ridiculous. He should be able to get in here, at least at a discounted price. Can't these ticket guys do anything about this?
Yeah, so, is that absolutely ridiculous?
It is absolutely ridiculous.
There's also another problem. That is these little rugrats we like to call kids. They're always running across the back part of my porch. Sooner or later, I'm gonna install an electric fence. This electric fence is gonna shock these little kids and make them think twice about running across my porch.
How exactly do you get that equipment, the electric fence, since you don't leave your porch?
I order it from eBay. Hey! Keep it down over there! Anyways, sorry. That's another problem here. It gets quite loud during game days, and the crowd's here, and I'm trying to just have a peaceful night at home. Maybe take a couple naps, watch some of the television. Yes, I get television. See these little, there's TVs around this stadium. And there's a big one out there. That's my big screen. That's my baby out there. She's about... Actually, I don't have a clue how big she is, but... That's where I get my daily source of television. Hey! Anyways, where were we? Do I sleep here? What kind of question is that? Of course I sleep here. This is my home. Where am I supposed to go? Some Super 8 motel? Some fancy Holiday Inn? No. This is where I live. This is my place of peace. And quiet. Keep it down! I'm trying to do an interview! People these days, they got no respect. No respect at all.
Respect, peace and quiet, and peace of mind is all that Michael desires.
This is my home. Where am I supposed to go? Some Super 8 motel? Some fancy Holiday Inn?
America's favorite pastime is both his friend and his enemy. Bound by the law of the chiefs and his own determination, Michael has no plans of leaving his little slice of paradise. His porch will remain an O'Brien Field monument.